In the previous video, we took a look at how we can change the author name within commits, even if they're already pushed onto the remote server. In this video, we're going to look at another common use case, which is a commit has been actually pushed up onto the remote server, which shouldn't have been pushed. Either it's not working or for some other reason. As I mentioned in the previous video, it's often the case, especially when you're working collaboratively, that you would correct any errors just by reverting commits using normal methods, either creating a new commit which corrects the problem by typing git revert and then the commit number, whatever that might be. This however does leave the original copy of the commit on the server and just creates a revert commit. There are however occasions when you want to actually completely delete the original content. Maybe for example for copyright infringement, for example, where you want to remove the actual initial version completely. If we look at the git log, we could for example completely delete this second to most recent commit here. To do this, all we need to do is exit the git log by pressing Q, and we'll do that by typing git rebase minus I, and we'll just go back two commits on this occasion. So just head tilde 2. So all we need to do is select the line that we want to delete and actually delete it. If we save that and close the file, that will go ahead and delete that actual commit from our history. So if we look at git log now, we can see that there was a file between these two, which is now gone. And if we look at git status, we can see that we're still rebasing. So now all we need to do is type git rebase continue and hit enter, and that will go ahead and delete that for us and update our branch. And as you can see, the actual commit has completely disappeared. As I said at the start of this video, it's often the case that you don't actually want to delete the entire commit, and there are plenty of other ways to achieve the same result without breaking the history for every single person who's working on the project. In the next video, we're going to be looking at alternative clients to the GitHub provided clients, both the GitHub Windows client and the GitHub terminal. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that.